Okay, so let's get started. This tutorial is gonna be on how to get started making a flight simulator game. I can't show you how to make the whole game. I still haven't got the shooting mechanic figured out. Although I had it figured out at one point. So, Shift A. Let's see. Scale, no. X. This is gonna be a pretty horrible looking jet or plane. However, you wanna call it see build, decimate, mirror, let's see. Looking for smooth. In wireframe smooth, there it is. Wait. What the heck? Doesn't look smooth at all. Okay, so we're just gonna scale gonna scale up a little bit. We're gonna a Shift A, add a plane. Let's see, scale and I don't know, that might be a little too big. Yeah, that might be a little too big. Scale down. That doesn't look square. Scale very important that this is very square. No, not the, yeah. Okay, scale. Let's see, 2. Hey. Okay. Let's edit. And then grab this one. And so grab that looks like a wing, right? Okay, so this is. We want both sides to look the same, so let's see, this one is 2.768. Hold on. Object mode. Move this one. And also, the problem with the problem with just turning this over is that it won't show up in play mode. Edit mode. Grab. That looks perfect. Whoops. still in edit mode. Object mode. Bring this dude into the middle. Move it back a little bit. Okay. Okay. We're gonna go back into edit mode. And grab dang it. We're gonna go to edit mode. I should have downloaded some kind of camouflage texture that would have really made it look real. Grab object mode, move that dude. Oh, wait, I should probably color it first. Color. And you'll probably have to mess around with texture painting. I'll probably look that up for you and learn how to do it. It's probably not that much different than, why did I put new? That doesn't look even. Oh, well, I guess we're gonna join it up. Join. We gotta go to object, then look, is it under transform? Object, transform, and then you go geometry to origin to wait, no, we want it to go to the center. There we go. And this is gonna be extremely easy, depending on how you want your jet to look, and then I haven't created an environment, so you just go over here to game logic and you can go always and unless you want to move it manually and go crap, and you can add a propeller and rigify the propeller and have it, I can teach you how to make it spin the whole time, like nonstop. Let's see. Okay. Okay, let's see. That was unexpected. I did not want to. Okay, so we are going to go back into default. And we're gonna take our wing. And we will go join. Now go into edit mode. Whoa. And we are going to, oh yeah, by the way, you gotta hold down control shift to, yeah, and you figure out how to smooth those things yourself. Okay. Now, hold down Control Shift, then we'll X vertices, then that's, yep, that's the, not origin, but yeah, I don't remember what it is right now. I believe it's called the grid. Okay. Well, it's not perfect, but that's okay. Okay, back to game logic. P. There we are. Okay, now we want to go blah 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 blah. Keyboard, keyboard. up, down, and motion. Character motion and let's see instead of location you're gonna put rotate. Let's see, okay, so for up, you're gonna rotate on the Y, plus on the Y, and then on down, you're gonna put minus on the Y. Okay, so for this one, we're gonna wanna go to default. Maybe we'll get the tool shelf out of the way and we'll go wait. It's not connected, is it? Okay, let's see. Default. And you can slow it down if you want. I mean, I'm not stopping you either way, so. What the heck? Game logic. Character motion. And it's connected. Oh. Oh, it's because it's. How did it get right shift? Okay. P. Yeah, it goes up, goes down. Yeah, I might need to speed that up so you guys can see it. Once again, you can speed this up or slow it down. I don't care. And I'm not stopping you, so you do what you want to do. Add sensor keyboard. Right. Left and the if you want to add guns. When you get that figured out, or when I get it figured out, you might want those to be like Z and X, or space bar, or whatever. Motion. Character motion. And rotate on the Z for the right. And oh, wait. Motion, character motion, And you guys might have to figure out the collision and I guess how to add AI so you can have some enemy planes on there. And or maybe you guys could have some land vehicles on there. Default. Okay, so hit P. Yeah, I might need to make the turning a little bit faster. Yeah, still need to make the turning faster. Yeah, so that's pretty much how you make a flight simulator. Okay, so if you wanna make a cockpit in your plane, you have to go to wait, actually, I don't think you can do this in edit mode. Oh well, let's give it a try. And I mean, there's other ways to do this. Okay, let's see. Nazi mask. I thought that while I never realized how different Range Engine was from Blender. I mean, there's a lot of similarities, but there's a lot of differences, too. So let's see. Why I'm doing this one at a time. I'm not 100% sure. I could probably just do it like this to save some time. I just don't want to end up let's see. Vertex group. Mask. Adjust what? Display modifier in edit mode. Display modifier and viewport. Let's see. Adjust. Edit. So let's see. Okay, I thought mask was the way to do it. But there's another way. I know there is. And I believe it's right here, and they have transparency. Hold on. Let's see. Level of detail. Parent display. Okay. Wow, this is really different from Blender. Motion duplication display. There it is, transparency. But it's not looking transparent. Parent object. See solid. No. Bounds, wire, no. Okay. I show you guys basically how to make a flight simulator. You guys can have fun with that, and then let's see, what's this? Guess that's nothing. I guess you guys will just have to figure out how to add or how to make the glass looking thing. You can put the camera in there, and but you can't see through the thing unless you make like a glass type of texture. So maybe we can figure this out. Transparency. I'm guessing that's the transparency of the... Wait a second. I hope you all watch until the end, or at least until this part, because it seems like, see, add, subtract, multiply. Yeah, see, this is a lot of stuff I didn't know the range engine had. Okay, hold on. I'm gonna try to add a texture add new. Well, I guess I don't need a new one. See if does the there it is, transparency. Damn it. Transparency. Fuse. It's not showing up transparent, though. Okay, we're learning here. Okay, mask. Wait a second. I don't know what's going on. It doesn't look very transparent to me. Surface wire volume. Oh. Oh, a sign. Oh, that's sweet. I don't know if I'm gonna remember how to do this, but I will always remember having fun doing it. Yeah, hold on. Let's make the cockpit a little bit bigger. Okay, assign. Let's see, where's the camera now? Okay. So we'll bring. Control Z. Into object mode. So, it doesn't look great. It's probably too transparent. I could probably change that if I wanted to, but I've been working on this for too long. For today. Actually, I don't have anything else to do. I could. I could change it. Let's see. Rotation. So, rotate the Z nine zero. Rotate on the Y 90. Okay, we're gonna go to viewpoint camera. We're gonna go grab on the Y, no, on the X. We're gonna okay, go back to viewpoint. Front. The wings look invisible. Oh, now they're visible. And then you can put a seat in there if you so please. And you can put a steering wheel in there. I'm not, just for the sake of this tutorial. So I'm gonna save it. Save as flight sim tutorial. And let's see. This is probably gonna change the whole thing, so you're probably gonna wanna put the camera in the vessel, ship, whatever, before you or yeah, before you add the game logic. And then you go Control P object, and let's see, view camera viewpoint camera. Gonna wanna make that a little higher and go P. So front okay, gonna viewpoint camera. Okay, that's perfect. Let me guess, I have to add new game logic now. I thought so. Wait, I'm not sure yet, but I bet I do. Okay, so we are going to go default. A We're gonna go view viewpoint front and shift A. Let's add a plane. Rotate. on the rotate on the Y 90. Oh, that's blue. Oh, well. Scale 9. Scale 9. Push that back a little bit more. Okay. Shift A. Add a cube. Just to let us know that we're actually going forward. New Am I facing the wrong way? Is my plane facing the wrong direction? Where is it? It is location, location, location. The X, it's 3.282. 3.282. Okay, so I guess it's gotta be on the y. -4.675. -4.675. You point camera. Okay. View. Front. Viewpoint front viewpoint front. Okay, it must just be too far away for the camera to see. Or well, you can tell that it's moving. Hold on. Front. And you can make the camera see farther, I think. Not 100% sure. camera, transform, relations, object, groups, display, x-ray, motion paths, custom properties, wire, display, delta transform, transforms, relations, I know you can make it see further. You might have to figure this out for yourself. I don't know. Turning up the resolution isn't gonna help. Let's see. No. Well, the one that looks like the camera makes sense. Clopping. Shift. What's this? Horizontal, no. Level of detail. Custom viewpoint. That may be it. Display. I don't know. We're gonna see what that does. And we're gonna leave it. We might leave it there. I mean, it might kill me to leave it there, but... There we are. Front, front, front. Let's see, front, 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 front. Oh, I just made the camera bigger. Okay, let's see. We're gonna go... Wait, where's all the information at? Oh, there it is. Location... on the X. Grab on the Y. Grab on the Y. Camera. Shift D. Shift D. I mean, it doesn't look professional, but it's starting to look like something I might play. Grab on the Z. Grab on the X. Grab on the Y and the X. Yeah, at this point, I'm just kind of showing off. Grab. I need to stop this video now or it's gonna take forever for it to, for YouTube to accept it. Grab on the, no. Grab on the X. Okay, let's see. And we'll get into collision. We'll get into collision in the next video. And I gotta end this now, or the it's just gonna take forever to for YouTube to put the video through. So we'll mess with this some more in the next video. Until then, I was gonna say stay perfect, but nobody's perfect, so take care of yourselves, and I will see you guys in the next video. Thanks for watching.